Good evening, everyone. India woke up on Janmashtami morning to some good news and some bad news. The good news was that Kamala Harris, a person of Jamaican and Indian-American origin, has been picked by Joe Biden to be his running mate for the post of Vice President of the United States. And she's, of course, the first Black woman to be on a major ticket, and certainly the first person of South Asian descent to also be on a major ticket. So India celebrating, a lot of people saying that's fantastic. It's good to have somebody of Indian origin there on the ticket with Joe Biden. She was, of course, a front runner for a while, and then it looked as if she was dropping away. But Kamala Harris now has a very strong chance to be the Vice President of the United States. On the bad news side, the violence and the tension and the rioting in Bengaluru. That after a social media post that many found objectionable, and then crowds came out, there was rioting, there were deaths, there was police firing. Bengaluru seems to be settling down a little bit right now. There have been multiple arrests, and let's hope that the police are able to maintain some sort of peace and order. Anybody guilty, whatever the reason is, anybody who's guilty of rioting and violence needs to be dealt with, and needs to be dealt with in a very strong manner. Let's just quickly bring you up to date with all the big stories of the day.
Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden has named Indian origin Senator Kamala Harris as his vice presidential running mate, making history by selecting the first Black woman to compete on a major party's presidential ticket. 55-year-old Harris, whose father is an African from Jamaica and mother an Indian, is currently the U.S. Senator from California and often has been described as a trailblazer by former President Barack Obama. Taking to Twitter, shortly after the announcement, Harris said she was honored to join Biden as nominee for Vice President and would do what it takes to make him our Commander-in-Chief.
You can't know who Kamala Harris is without knowing who our mother was. Maya Harris, the sister of Joe Biden's running mate, tweeted after the nomination. Kamala Harris is the first South Asian American woman and the second Black woman in history to serve in the US Senate, and only the fourth woman in US history to be running in the presidential race. Maya shared an emotional collage of the California senator's photos over the years, showing their mother's heritage as a strong woman from Chennai who migrated to the United States to study science. Kamala is seen through her various speeches thanking her mother for the hardships she went through and making it possible for Kamala to continue the fight and be able to run in the presidential race.
The fact that my mother never asked anyone permission to tell her what was possible is why, within one generation, I stand here as a serious candidate for President of the United States.
Maya tweeted, "You can't know who Kamala Harris is without knowing who our mother was. Missing her terribly, but know she and the ancestors are smiling today."
China has declined to react to U.S. Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden's move to pick Kamala Harris as his running mate. But the country's official media said that the Indian American's nomination will add fuel to the current conflict between the two sides. The Chinese analyst said Harris's strong stand on human rights issues relating to Xinjiang and Hong Kong will complicate matters. Harris in the past has called for increasing pressure on China for human rights violation against Uyghur Muslims of Xinjiang and the crackdown against the pro-democracy movement in Hong Kong. But she also rejected President Donald Trump's tariff war on China. Curfew has been imposed in parts of Bengaluru that witnessed large-scale violence and arson on Tuesday night. A communal social media post by a relative of a Congress MLA triggered massive protests in the city. Protesters attacked MLA Srinivas Murthy's residence, vandalized it and damaged the vehicles parked there. Three people have been reportedly killed in the police firing and over 50 policemen have also sustained injuries. Protesters also vandalized a police station. 110 people accused of the violence have been arrested, the Bengaluru Police Commissioner said. Chief Minister Yediyurappa has said that his government won't tolerate any provocations and violence.
A day after witnessing a dip below 60,000 in single-day COVID cases after four straight days of 60,000-plus cases, India again recorded close to 61,000 new infections on Wednesday. According to the Health Ministry data on Wednesday morning, the country's COVID tally crossed 23 lakh with the latest spike. With 834 new fatalities, the number of deaths due to coronavirus has gone past 46,000. Close to 16.5 lakh people have recovered from the highly contagious disease, taking the recovery rate to 70.37%. For the past 7 days, India's single-day count of COVID-19 cases has been more than that of the US and Brazil, the two worst-hit nations in terms of infections, according to an analysis of WHO data. India, the third worst-hit nation in terms of infections, has also accounted for over 23% of the cases and more than 15% of the deaths reported worldwide between August 4th to the 10th, the data shows. India recorded over 4 lakh COVID-19 cases and 6,251 deaths due to the disease in the span of 7 days till August 10th. In the same period, the US, which is at the number one spot in terms of the cases and deaths, registered over 3.5 lakh infections and 7,232 deaths.
Rebel Congress leader Sachin Pilot's return to the party has an Uttar Pradesh assembly election twist. According to a report in Hindi newspaper Hindustan, it was Priyanka Gandhi Vadra who ironed out the differences between Ashok Gehlot and Pilot, who comes from the Gujar community. The report said Congress felt Pilot's need not just for elections in Rajasthan but Lok Sabha polls as well. As Priyanka is preparing the ground for 2022 Uttar Pradesh Assembly elections, at least 55 seats in the state are dominated by the Gujar community, where Pilot holds considerable sway. If Pilot had quit the Congress, which has lost ground in the key state, the party would have suffered in these pockets. Apart from this, the community can also decide the fortunes of elections in 14 seats in Madhya Pradesh.